Good morning, children.
Good morning.
All of you, open your cameras. So, children, today what we'll do is we are going to do a little revision. Okay? I'm going to dictate you a few lines, and what you'll do, you will write in the chat box. Let me see whether you can do it, whether you can understand it nicely or not. Okay, ready for it? All right. Listen to it very carefully. The first sentence, this is the revision from chapter number 6, Lesson 6. Correct? We have only one chapter coming in the UT. All of you, please open your cameras. Yes? We have only one chapter coming in the UT. Yes. So we are going to do the complete revision from that chapter. I'm going to use all the vocabulary, all the words that have been used in this chapter, and accordingly, you have to listen to it and you have to figure out what I am speaking. The first sentence is, let me see who can understand it correctly. Les amis sont espagnol. Les amis sont espagnol. Come on, type. If you're not able to understand, you can ask me.
Please repeat the sentence one more time.
Okay. Les amis sont espagnol. Les amis sont espagnol.
When we have to add these in fair notebook.
No, beta, you have to write it in the chat box. Okay. Neha Gangwar, the first two words are correct. The third word. Okay, what do I mean when I say les amis sont espagnol? Can anybody tell me what I mean when I say this? The friends, what is les amis?
Mom, the friends.
Okay. What I'm saying about these friends, the friends son espanol.
The
yes. Try.
I think that these friends are from Spain.
Very nice. They are Spanish. So if I say les amis son espanol, what is the word used for our Spanish, A-R-E. S-O-N-T. It should be S-O-N-T. Okay. Les amis son espanol.
Okay, ma'am. I heard a song.
Now type the correct sentence. See, if I say les amis sont espagnol, very nice, very good, very good, very good. But everyone is making one mistake. Now, what is that mistake? Now, see my sentence and and just try to figure out. Yes, what? Try to figure out.
Ma'am, the last word.
Yes, very nice.
Ma'am, because it's the friends are, so ma'am, it will be cooler.
Yes, I'm typing two sentences. From these two sentences, you will come to know what mistake you were making. Can you see my two sentences?
Yes, ma'am.
This is the spelling of army is different. With A-M-I-S, I'm going to put Espanol. Okay, wait, children, give me a minute. I'm just going to get my whiteboard and then explain you. Okay, see, look here. I told you that we always take care of genders, right? What is Lay's army? Lay's army is used for boys or girls, tell me. What is it used for?
I'm friends.
For boys. Why? Because there is no E over there. Army is boy. If I want to make it, if I talk about a girl, I'll put E after it. Is that correct? So here, when I say Les army son espanol. Son espanol. I am talking about plural friends. And these friends are masculine in gender. So my nationality should also be masculine and plural. It should match. Is it clear?
You yes, got my it? Man.
All right. Now, what is the next sentence? The next sentence goes, Je quatorze ans. Now, let me see how many of you can type it correctly. J'ai 14 ans.
Can you repeat the sentence?
The sentence is J'ai 14 ans.
Ma'am, may you repeat the last word?
J'ai 14 ans. Ans.
Please, you can repeat the last word.
Okay, so I have answer from Arshia. J'ai 14 ans. Very nice. Correct. What about others? Are you not able to understand beta? Are you not able to understand? Are you not able to write it this way?
Mom, send.
Okay, very nice. So I have answers only from Arshia, Neha, and Amesha. What about others? Dheve, Rishit, Kaustubh. Everybody, please open your cameras. All of you, please open your cameras. What is wrong, beta? Are you not able to understand? Rishit, Dheere, Kaustubh, open your cameras, all of you. Okay, now your answers should be sent to me directly. Okay, nobody will send it to everyone. The next is an easy one. Il est français. Il est français. Now let me see.
Send.
Very nice, Amesha. Good. Il est français. One more time for others. Very good, Neha. Il est français. How do you write ill? Tell me. Ill.
I-L.
I-L. Ill. A. Ill. A. Now what is A? Ill. A. Francais. E-S-T. Now what do I mean when I say ill est français? He is
French. From France. France.
Okay. Ill. A. Francais. Everybody look up in the chat box. This is what I was speaking. Il est français. Before this sentence, my sentence was, what was my sentence? J'ai 14 ans. J'ai 14 ans. And before that, what was my sentence? Les amis sont Espanol. Les amis sont Espanol. Remove that A from there. There is no A in between. Now, children, I want all of you to type the answer. Listen to me very carefully. The line is Je le livre de français. Je le livre de français.
Ma'am, may you repeat?
Je le livre de français. Je le livre de français. Now, children, see how I'm speaking. Try to break the words. Very nice, Neha. Very good. Je le livre de français. Good, Kaustubh. Very good, Neha Gangwar. See, they have typed the answer in the chat box.
Ma'am, can you explain of il est français?
What, beta? Very good, Amesha.
Ma'am, can you explain of il est français?
Ma'am, I'm sitting.
Okay. See, when I said il est français, we don't say it. First of all, see, that is why I tell you to pay attention to the pronunciation. I always make you write the pronunciation along with the words that we come across, isn't it? So that when you listen to any French thing, you can actually relate what the word is. Now you are saying il est français, but because you keep speaking it est, so you will not understand what a is. The correct word is, the correct pronunciation is il est français. Est is not est, it's a. And it means he is French. Okay? He is French. Il est français. Je le livre de français. Okay, yes. The next one is.
Ma'am, I'm also saying.
Yes, Arshia, very nice. But it should not be D-E-S. It should be D-E. Why? Because we are talking about one book. I have the book of French. So in that case, we should put D-E, not D-E-S. The next sentence is, okay, listen to it very carefully. Pedro ate Italian. Pedro ate Italian.
Ma'am, I'm not sure.
Very
about
nice. This yes. Now, Amesha, again, what do I mean when I say Pedro a Italian? Tell me the English translation of this sentence.
Ma'am, Pedro is Italian.
Is, very nice. Now, Amesha, when you know I mean is, then what is the word for is? Is it et? Aviral, beta, I can't hear you. You have some network issue. Please type in the chat box. Your voice is breaking.
It's E-T and E-S-T.
Yes, it should be E-S-T. Aviral, very nice. Your answer is correct in the chat box. Pedro, a Italian. Amesha, Arshia, correct. And who else has sent the answer? Anyone else? Amesha, Arshia, Neha Gangwar. Very good. Costco. Very nice. Who is not sending me answers? That's Rishit and Dhere. Now, for Rishit and Dhere, I have one very simple sentence. Como talevu? Okay, very nice. Neha Gangwar has sent it. Now, Rishit and Dhere, we've learnt it in the beginning. Como talevu means how are you? What is that? Como talevu?
Como talevu means how are you?
So, how do you write it, beta? How do you write it? Come on, write it and show it to me. How it's written.
Ma'am, may you repeat?
Como talevu?
I'm just right.
Okay, very nice. Rishit, very nice. Neha Gangwar. Amesha, beta, you didn't get it correct. Como talevu? Como alevu? Como? But what is the correct way of speaking? It's como talevu. Como talevu. Very nice, Arshia. Very nice. Yes, now I'll write the spelling. How do you ask how are you in a formal way? It's como talevu. C-O-M-M-E-N-T Ale A-L-L-E-Z and V-O-U-S. Como talevu. Okay?
Okay.
Next, everyone, I want you to write Les amis de Caroline. Now it's very easy. Les amis de Caroline.
Mom, please give some hard sentences.
Now you want me to give you some difficult ones?
Very ma'am, nice. Not to guess from Zoom.
Amesha, Aviral, Rishit, Arshia, all correct. Now tell me, should I raise the level?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Now next one. Je suis médecin. Je suis médecin. Médecin is what? It's used for doctor. Je suis médecin.
Mom, if a doctor is called médecin, then what is a medicine called?
Medicine. Now medicine is called médicament. Yes.
Ma'am, I cannot join the meeting from Zoom app. Ma'am, I have to join it from the browser.
Okay.
So what yes, is ma'am, wrong if there you join it from the browser?
Even if you join it from the browser, then what's wrong? Sometimes it happens. We can't join it from Zoom, but directly from the browser.
Ma'am, in browser, I cannot hear you.
You can't hear me. Now, beta, then what is the issue? Why can't you join it from Zoom? What does it say?
Ma'am, what is it?
What?
Ma'am, please repeat.
Je suis médecin. Now, what is the spelling of médecin? I'll type it in the chat box, children, for you. You might not know this. It's M-E-D-E-C-I-N. Je suis médecin. And the first E has accent grave. Sorry, accent aigu. Je suis médecin. Very nice. Good. The next sentence is, now very carefully listen to it. Nous avons une voiture rouge. Nous avons une voiture rouge.
Ma'am, may you repeat?
Ma'am, can I repeat?
My sentence was, nous avons une voiture rouge. Now break it. The first two words are, nous avons.
Ma'am, what is after nous avons?
Nous avons une voiture. Now, what is une voiture? And then the last word is rouge. Nous avons une voiture rouge.
Mama, I didn't got the spelling of voiture.
Okay. What is a voiture? Tell me. Do you know what a voiture is?
No, ma'am.
No. All of you know what a voiture is. Now let me type it, Mama, in the chat box. All of you know. Now, how many of you know what a voiture is? Yes. Very good, Amesha. Neha Gangwar, don't you know what a voiture is? Yes?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, yes. It means a car.
It means a car. But now when you don't look at the word and only you listen to it, you actually cannot relate to it, huh? Okay, now type your sentence correctly. Nous avons une voiture. Now, what do I mean when I say une voiture? Type it and show it to me.
And what is avant in English?
What is avant?
In English.
Have. Avant is have. Beta, it comes from avoir verb. What is the verb?
Okay, ma'am.
Yes? Okay, ready for the next sentence? Ready for the next sentence?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. The next sentence is, Neha habite en France. Neha habite en France. Okay, very nice. Aviral, very nice.
Can you repeat?
Very nice, Amesha. But why are you putting A-O? Sorry, A-U. When I say Neha Abid au France, what do I mean? Now, children, see. I have told you this thing that before feminine countries, what we put, and before masculine, what is supposed to come? France is what? Which country? What is the gender of France? Tell me.
Ma'am, feminine.
Feminine. Feminine. So what do we put before feminine countries?
Ma'am,
E-N. What is the gender of Japan?
Ma'am, masculine.
Masculine. What are we going to put?
Ma'am, A-U.
A-U. What is the gender of she?
Ma'am, feminine.
Feminine. What are we going to put before it?
Ma'am, E-N.
E-N. What is the gender of Eta Zuni? What is the gender of Eta Zuni? What are we going to put before it?
A-U-X.
Ma'am,
A-U-X.
So children, when you listen to sentences like these, you have to apply all these rules. You have written Neha,
what is
O-France. Now that makes your sentence wrong if you write A-U before it. Isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, what is the meaning of Abid?
Abid means to live.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, is my sentence is
correct? When I say Jabi, Bareilly. What do I mean? I live in Bareilly. I live in Bareilly. Okay? If I say Thu Abid, where do you live? Again, I'm going to repeat. Thu Abid, the same two words. Bareilly. You live in Bareilly. Okay? Now, ready for the next sentence?
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next sentence is Nu Som Bo. Now let me see how many can write it correctly. Nu Som Bo.
I'm saying.
Very nice, Amesha. Absolutely correct.
And what was the last word?
Bo. The last word is bo. Now, when I say Nu Som Bo, just do a little this thing. Apply your mind where we have used the word bo, what it means. Now, if we are using the word with nu, how is the word supposed to come? If we are using the word with nu, how is bo supposed to come with nu? How it's going to come? My sentence is Nu Som
Plural
Bo, B-E-A-U-X. Isn't it? Nu Som Bo. Only Amesha answered it correctly. The next sentence. Okay, the next is a very simple one. Set yun fi. Set yun fi. What do I mean when I say set yun fi?
Can you repeat the sentence again?
Set tune fee. Set tune fee. Set tune fee. What does it mean? What do I mean when I say set tune fee? Okay, Amesha has typed it correctly. Very nice. Neha Gangwar, correct. What about you, Sarthak? Why are you not replying?
It is a girl.
Yes, this is a girl. Set tune fee. Now, children, I think that you are finding this class very difficult. Today's class is the most difficult one, is it?
Ma'am, it's the most easiest one.
It's the most easiest one. Okay.
Yes, ma'am, the questions are really easy.
All right, now the next one. Des garçons. Des garçons. On. Une chaise. Des garçons ont une chaise. Now let me see.
Ma'am, can you?
The sentence is Des garçons ont une chaise. Okay. Amesha, did I say the garçons? What did I say? I said Des garçons. First of all, this Des garçons. On. Okay, you're not able to understand this word? Fine, let's leave it. Now, when I say une chaise, des garçons dash une chaise is easy to understand, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Boys dash a chair. Now, what will come here according to you? If you translate it in English also, what should it be filled with? Boys have a chair, isn't it? Boys have a chair. So what? And I said on. So what will come? Des garçons ont une chaise.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. All right, so I think children, everybody please open your cameras, all of you. How did you find the class? Difficult? Unable to understand?
I'm easy.
It was being tough to figure out what the teacher is speaking. And when?
But some sentences.